We are here, TUT emalahleni Week Bank. These are the leaders of the students. I'm going to ask them several questions so that they can tell us and address us what is happening behind them. Because we see a lot of students, they are striking. My leaders, what is this strike all about?
Thank you very much. It's not a strike.
Okay.
It's a protest. We have gathered out here and we are not saying, no one is striking inside. What you are seeing there is picketing. The gate was not closed by students, was closed by officers and police. So we are not in the forefront of any strike. We are academics, we don't strike. So we don't have any strike in our campus. We are doing a picketing demonstration that we demand accommodation immediately. So what you are doing here is not a strike at all, my leader. What you are doing here is a demonstration, and it is outside, it is far away from the gate of the university. The university is open, but the bouncer decided to record us and close the university. Even now, I was supposed to go and submit my assignment inside, but because it's closed, I won't have to go inside.
Okay, my leader, thank you. And then I have heard that you have touched an issue of accommodation. Can you tell me more about accommodation?
Yes, I will also allow my leader to speak on that one. But what you must know about accommodation, we are not only saying we need accommodation now. We further say the fees that were being charged from the accommodation, it is not genuine and it was not processed in a formal manner. We don't know. It's a surprise embarrassment. No one can charge you more than 35,000. Just to see, as if we are renting in a guest house. So we are not going to stay anywhere in a guest house. We are going to defy them. We are not going to pay that because it is only our parents who pay that. We are not going to pay that. We have declared before and even today we are declaring. We are not going to pay that. So my dad will come up and also brief.
Okay.
Thank you very much. I think we are touching on issues that are very much more paramount. You see, this thing doesn't only affect our students, it also affects parents at home. As much as you are an NSFAS student, you can't pay 35,000. And now we are striking for those 253 students that they don't have accommodation, which are residing on sheds. Yesterday we saw it, we experienced it. So it is not a conducive place for students to stay in, and it's not a conducive place for students to study in. So we as leadership, we have declared that we can't allow that. Recently they are saying we are paying 35,000 annual. If you are a foundation phase student, it means you must finish your course 4 years. So basically if you can calculate that 34,000 by four, it's totally out of order. And when we confront the management about this thing, they tell us that this thing was a mistake. How can you make a mistake of our money? And at the end of the day, even the savings delivering the accommodation, the very same accommodation, which is 35,000, is very much poor. So we can't allow that. We can't strike it. We know that we are NSFAS users, but we are not paying that money indirectly. But one day when we find employment, we are going to pay for that. So we are saying, if there's a mistake, let them come to board and make sure that clarity, we see clarity and legitimacy of this thing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, my leaders. This is emalahleni TUT, and the students, they are out of the gate because the bouncers have closed the gate for them. And they are paying more on their rest while they get less services. Thank you.